them at least a safe haven for now.
We'll be right back.
All right, hello and welcome back to week 6 of the Spring Split presented by XP League. And what a day do we have for you today. Apex Legends starting off with our Gold League, and then later on we'll be moving into Fortnite with our Gold, Silver, and Platinum League. So stay tuned for that as well, but we'll see how this map plays out today. We're going to be starting off on Stormpoint and loading in and seeing where these players are starting off their drops today. We'll take a look at the map so we can take a view at what teams are going where.
You gotta love what you do. Mine's taking you down.
We'll see how these teams continue to adapt week after week to put themselves into positions to win matches. And they're going to begin to dive in here. Five teams starting their descent here at the start of the map, and then a few others just kind of waiting a little bit longer to drop off here. We'll take a look over here. Maybe some teams contesting each other. Not too many teams in the match. 14 squads, so a lot of locations that are going to be left open. So we'll see what teams contest each other and try to battle it out to claim their spot early in this match. It seems like one of these teams is going to be Franklin Wales. Looking around here, we have Spiff, we have Pokey Mini-Me, and I think it's Gary. A really long name there. Gary Bikini Bottom SpongeBob Patrick. That is the full name, but we'll just call him Gary for now, and we'll be switching between these two teams as they battle it out. Gnome Darts nearby, a strong team to be facing off against, but you can't count out Franklin Wales. They've dominated in these games prior. They've shown how great they can be in these matches. Arcstar's being thrown out, that car in the hands of Arkham. Looking to put some space in between each other, that Nemesis as well. Looks like Franklin Wales just looking to regroup on top of the building here. They have space to work with. The Prowler, that Alternator in the hands of Spiff. He's going to take that information just given there by Gary into account. Look around here, maybe try to find one of these players caught out, but for now remain a stalemate as both of these teams not looking to aggress too early on, trying their best to set up for a little bit of an advantage themselves. But as they set up, we'll switch over here to another team, Franklin Phoenix, one of the dominant teams in these matches, Hanover Horde. We'll see what they can do against Franklin Phoenix. Dude, he's got to be careful here. Booger very low on HP as well, and Slug Life has the most HP on the team. Dude, he's going to be able to pop those shield cells to get back some of that health, some of that HP, but looks like Franklin Phoenix are wanting to get aggressive here. The quad goes down, though. Dario may be quick to follow here. Misty now left in a difficult situation, just trying to play behind her teammate. Dario will be taken out, and Misty now has so much to do in this fight. We'll find that Kraken shield. We'll find that knock. Misty sets up nicely for this fight. One player now, a 1v2. Teammate still alive, Rezzable at this point, but a difficult situation now. Slug Life will be taken out. Booger and Doogie have to be careful here. Very low on HP, but Booger's gonna get aggressive here, and it won't go his way. Now Doogie, the only player left remaining here. Misty trying to find that damage, trying to find those shots with the triple take, and it's not gonna go their way. Hanover Horde will find those eliminations, and what a team to take out here at the beginning for this squad. Franklin Phoenix will drop, and Hanover Horde taking a nice fight here at the start, putting themselves ahead in this match and giving them a few elimination points to start off. Hanover Horde, not a team that we talk about too often, but they've came to play today, and Franklin Phoenix will be dropped early on into this match, so obviously a change of play style working out here for this team, and a dominant performance here at the start for them. Painting our way back around the map here, we'll take a look at the top left corner here, where we have Troy, Evo, B, Yoking, and EJ, Dead Rider. looking to get some upgrades here on the edge of the map. Just a duo here. And I don't know if this team is normally a duo. I don't remember exactly, but in this match, they're at a man disadvantage. They're going to have to play around that, try and find some early damage in these fights, get a nade down, get some shield cracks going before they are able to take too aggressive of an approach on these squads. Though the name of the game is mostly survival, so we'll see what they can do. We'll see if they can survive late into this match and put themselves in a place to win it. You can look down here. Troy Evo A. Shrieker, and Vixity, and DJ 4 Pro taking out some spiders here, getting some more loot. And spiders, we don't see too many teams using them too often, but obviously getting a decent amount of loot. Upgrading those shields can just be so useful in the early parts of this match. Getting yourself some blue if you're on those gray shields. Giving you a little bit of shields along the way as well. So Troy Evo A gonna utilize those creatures and get those upgrades early on. One team stuck on the edge of zone out here though is another duo, the Gate Moth and Triangle XP12. It looks like Shogun is the name of this squad, and they're gonna be making their way into zone here, forced in from that storm. We'll see yet another duo trying to survive in these matches. So difficult to put yourself in a great position to take fights, especially win them. You're down a man. That's down in damage that you can deal out to these teams. So you just have to sneak your way around, find an advantage or an advantageous fight, and move on from there. But taking a look back at the map here, we might have a few teams running into each other. We have Towson, Triton, hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, but Lil Dog, CNH Gamer, and Mason K. Goodnight. Gonna be working their way around here. Nearby, another squad, no blades. Looks like they're looking around here. They might be aware of it, or at least cautious of the fact that there might be a team nearby. But nothing really being spotted out at this point. Saberific pretty separate from the squad up on the top of this building. While Prince Sloth and YT Salt are down below.
Now that is an upgrade.
Panning our way around here. Yeah, Saberific hears those footsteps. That flat line is brought out. We'll see if he can find that early damage to give him his teammates the advantage. He's pretty separate from his squad, so he has to be careful about taking a fight here, and the damage going through. Saberific brings one down to their knees. Flatline goes huge, pops the poison to get the elimination on this player. Once that quick heal him, and is gonna get it. Now his squad moving their way in. Mason has to be careful here, looking for the shots. Not gonna be enough damage though. Closes the door, trying to play around with the opening, closing it, but he's just not gonna be able to do enough here for his squad. And now CNH is on the prowl. Looking for this damage, finds that shield crack, finds a big chunk there with that Peacekeeper. Now just working his way around here, trying to find a little bit of damage, a little bit more to take out that Caustic, but it's not going to go his way, and has to reposition, gets that mark out, doesn't get any information from it though. Moves his way back in, finds the shield crack, finds the damage, but that poison slowing him down so much. Put in such a difficult situation here. Spraying down with that RE45. A little bit of damage dealt, but nothing too significant at this point. CNH, maybe no shields left on the inventory. See, that health is very low. As soon as I see that shield crack, it's going to be over, but he is able to reposition and finds a lot of damage onto this enemy squad. Damage coming through, but not going to be enough. CNH is dropped along with the rest of his squad. And they will go out. See zone closing in now. Saberific and that squad on the edge now. Prince Sloth was brought down very low, but they're able to survive the fight, and two eliminations will go their way, bringing their total to 2. Now going to be working their way into zone. So far out here, they have to be careful of it. Rotating in, and Prince Sloth, yeah, will go down to zone. It's going to be ticking pretty hard here. So now, YT Salt and Saber Ific are put in a difficult situation, trying to just survive for their lives here. And an edge zone fight so far out of zone just wasn't the right call for them. And all these medkits might give Saber Ific a chance to get out of zone here, but we'll come back to them later if they do survive. For now, let's take a look at some of these other fights going on inside of zone. Hanover Horde, they started off the game strong, and they're continuing on in this match with a few more fights on their hands. You can see these players on the other side of this door. Brought it open, finds the shield crack onto one. Booger, a nice few shots there coming through, but Dookie's got to be careful. Brought low here. And that's Troy Evo B. We're looking to do some damage here themselves. Nade's going out, but I don't think it was thrown properly. Maybe bouncing off of one of his teammates, and shield battery will be popped by Yoking. EJ, going to do some damage here as well. The squad, the duo, being forced back. Hanover Horde able to hold their ground for now. They've done so well. Hold these players off. Keep that advantage in their favor. See, nades coming out of that door, but nothing really going to land at this point. And now they'll just wait zone. Not necessarily favoring Hanover Horde here, but they have that player advantage. They don't want to give up any piece here. They don't want to get too aggressive. Just trying to find out exactly where these players are. Damage coming out, and the elimination found for Dookie. Some nice shots coming out with that flatline. And we'll see if they can work in here. You can see they're trying to break through these barriers in front of them and find the damage, but Slug Life is brought low. Dookie Muncher taken down. Slug Life, difficult situation. Booger very low as well, and they just survive here. And they will make it out of that for now. Gnome Darts. Looking to take a fight of their own. Kind of in the center of zone here. Not a lot of cover to play around except for these rocks. They could easily be picked off, but you're gonna see the reposition starting to come through here. As we pan our way back to the map, it looks like that original team we were looking at in zone was caught out. They weren't able to survive. Troy Evo A. Looking their way around here, trying to get some information on exactly where these players are. They've got a decent position playing up against this mountain. Nobody can come from above. It's from one of those ultimates, Valkyrie's ultimate, like that. And they see where those players are landing. Maybe some shots coming through, some damage, some upgrades for those shields. A Kraken shield for Invixity. A nice shot there. You see the reposition from these players around them. Guards also looking to take some damage on these players. Just have that hemlock to work with. Not really taking any shots though. Just jiggling the angle. Doesn't want to waste any ammo at this point. One of these teams rotating in late though is Flooperkid and Rain, a duo in this match as well. Got quite a few duos today, and we'll see how they stack up against these trios. Obviously put at a disadvantage already, but if they can survive long enough, they can put themselves in the right positions, they can still win these matches. Rain, you can see, holding out that ability. Popping some syringes, getting the health back up, but just gonna chill for now. Doesn't really want to take too many of these fights. You can see Gnome Darts, they have angles to take shots on these teams, but it's not worth it in their situation. These SMGs aren't gonna do that much damage. So they just need the information. They just want to know exactly where these teams are, rather than taking these shots at them. You see now, finally, damage coming through. Maybe just waiting for a shield crack on one of them. And it looks like Sandbean wants to get aggressive here. Gnome Darts on the offensive now. TJ 4 Pro laying off at EMP. Shrieker's gotta be careful. You're brought down very low on HP. You can see that medical drunk being popped in, that shield cell or shield battery as well. But now, Gnome Darts, they want to get aggressive here. Breaking down the door with that Rampart ultimate. And finding that damage, that minigun being so effective in these fights. And shots will come through. More damage being done. And a genius will clean it up and claim the kill leader crown of this match. And Gnome Darts putting themselves even further ahead of these teams. And claiming a decent portion of the zone. You can see some players beginning to rotate in here. Zero and Minty being one of these teams. Just on the edge zone yet again. Another one of these duos with so many of these duos in the match. Missing that one player makes it so difficult to give themselves the advantage. But you can see Zero, they're not going to shy away from it just yet. Minty shields given back. And you see that Valkyrie ultimate being popped. But Minty, before it's able to go off, is brought down and out. Zero caught on the edge of zone. The Nemesis to work with. The car to swap to. His teammate is not going to survive this one. See, for now, Zero able to find a little bit of a spot to sit in. But not the greatest place to be in. Hanover Horde looking great today. A good spot for them. Their center zone. They've only almost pulled the next one as well. And you see all these barriers, all these electric wires being set up here by Dookie. See what Gnome Darts can do. Obviously the favorites in this match. They've consistently dominated and shown why they're at the top of the leaderboard. And they'll continue to do so. Dr. Ingenious finds some chip damage on the edge of zone here. That team nearby, no mowers, the ones taking those shots. And a nice shot from the Sentinel. Knight Rider not going to go down easily, but as I say that, taken down very low. Air Demolition now being pressured from behind, and Midnight Rider will be taken out eventually. Another team taking these shots, and I don't know if Gnome Darts recognize that just yet. For now, they're going to back off. Reposition.
Let's go that way.
They're still looking at that position. You see the nade in Ingenious's hand, and he's going to toss that over there. And that nade will land nearby. Not going to do any damage, though. Just in front. Air Demolition actually taking out now. This team in such a difficult position. A dome shield comes out. And Midnight Rider will try to get his teammate back up as zone begins to push its way in. So this team very caught out here. Zone going to tick for a lot of damage. They don't take any of that damage, though, just yet. Midnight Rider. Shield almost cracked. Just going to play behind what little cover there is in this zone. Sentinel being brought out, but again, shots being fired. Hanover Horde going to be the one to find that damage, to find those eliminations, and there's one from Slug Life. This team looks reinvented today. Hanover Horde, we haven't seen them at the top of the leaderboard consistently, but today, they're making a name for themselves, and they're becoming one of the dominant teams in this lobby. And with a few solos left, it looks like the only team they're going to have to worry about now is Gnome Darts. And that isn't a small task. Gnome Darts, a veteran to these situations, consistently taking these fights, consistently looking for this damage. You'll see Sandbean going to be laying down some fire here with that minigun, with that Rampart ultimate, not allowing these players to rotate out of this zone just yet, rotate out of this building. Breaking through some of these barriers laid down there. Damage found. Crack shield. Very low HP on one of those solos. And again, Sandy can just sit here. Keep spraying those bullets. So much time to play with. Hanover Horde looks trapped in this building. Looks backed into a corner here, and they're going to have to rotate out eventually. But so is this Gnome Darts team, and it's going to come down to which team can survive that rotate. And it looks like it's not going to be Hanover Horde as one of their players is already taken down. Slug Life almost following here. And yeah, they're going to be chased down here. Gnome Darts wants to clean up the squad quickly, and they will find it. Hanover Horde drops, and now it's only solos to find here. No, excuse me, a duo with Shogun. They can still find this damage here. They can do the same thing that Gnome Darts was doing to the other squad, and they are going to find that damage. You see that shield crack, those nades coming out. Huge plays from this Shogun squad. Damage found. And one player will go down. It's all on to a gate against Ingenious. Genius trading out some shields there, playing behind some cover here. Damage going both ways. These players.
Right here, got one.
Such a difficult situation here. And now, Ingenious put in a difficult situation. They can get the res onto this player. He's trying to play around these shields. Ingenious brought low. A gate trying to do it all, trying to find this last little bit of damage with that Mastiff. Baiting out that shield cell, looking for those shots. Just can't land it just yet. Seal that shield battery coming out, playing behind this barrier. Laid down for him. And another one coming out as well. So many barriers to be broken through, and a gate trying to get off this shield battery. Can play behind this for a little bit longer. Is able to pop it off. Looks for the shots now. A gate in a great position to win this match. And he will do it. Shogun. A duo will find the end eliminations and win the match. What a play from a gate there to bring them back in that. I think he 1v3'd that squad and was able to win against Gnome Darts. We talked about how the duos would have such an impact on today's games. And if they'd be able to take out those trios, it looks like a gate is going to tell us or answer that question for us and take us to that victory. And we'll take a little look at the end results here. We'll take a look at the leaderboard and see how each team stacked up here in our match summary. Shogun, a duo with 7 eliminations, takes that victory. Gnome Darts with 10 in second. Hanover Horde with 6 in third. And Team 7 with 0 in 4th, and Gnome Mowers in 5th with 2. So that will wrap up our first match, but we have one more to come, so stay tuned for some more action. Alright, hello and welcome back to our second match of our Spring Split Week 6. After a banger of a first one, Agate clutching it up for his squad in that 1v3 situation and able to give them that first win in today's matches. We'll see if Shogun can continue that strong start as they have a third player this match. And with Agate performing like that, we'll see if he can lead them to victory yet again. But we will begin dropping into our second match of the day. Second and final match of Apex, and then we'll be working our way into Fortnite in our silver, gold, and plat leagues there. Franklin Phoenix had a tough start at the previous match, or in the previous match, and wasn't able to make it too far. A team that we usually see go so far in these matches, and teams like Hanover Horde and Shogun showed us what they could do and how dominant their teams can be as well in these matches if given the chance. And we'll see if these teams can make a name for themselves and break down those teams who are usually on top, like that Gnome Dart squad who came in second in the previous match. And again, we'll take our way up here towards the top of this match. Hanover Horde, round two with this Franklin Phoenix squad. And they're not playing around this time. Quad, Dario, and Misty are showing their dominance. They've already got one of these players down. Sluglife is that one. You can see them starting to push this position already. Getting aggressive here. Finding this damage. Dario able to find a shield crack there. Under one of these players, and Quad closing in here, trying to make his way in the top of this building, that Hemlock to work with, trying to surprise these players.